Before I begin my review, a statutory warning to all my patriotic Indian brothers and sisters. This is India bashing large scale. If you're the sort of person who gets all worked up when any aspect of India is criticized, this book is not for you. Let's begin. The White Tiger is a grim, biting, unsettled book at 21st century India, stuck in the mire of a corrupt, cynical past and debauching and slaughtering its way into a corrupt and cynical future. Told by a working class fellow who, through ambition, intelligence and a willingness to be utterly ruthless, is clawing his way up the rungs of the Indian class ladder. It paints a bleak of picture, offering little optimism for an Indian that will be any cleaner, fairer or more humane than the India it is replacing. Hello and welcome to Law Kanya. This video is about the book by Arvind Adiga. It's called The White Tiger. It was his first debut novel, first published in 2008 and won the 40th Man Booker Prize in the same year. Introducing a major literary talent, The White Tiger offers a story of enormous wit, blistering suspense and questionable morality, told by the most volatile, captivating and utterly inimitable narrator that this millennium has yet seen. It's about Balram Halwai, who is a complicated man, servant, philosopher, entrepreneur and even a murderer. Over the course of 7 nights by the shattered light of a preposterous chandelier, Balram tells us the terrible and transfixing story of how he became to be success in his life, having nothing but his own wits to help him along. Born in the dark heart of India, Balram gets a break when he is hired as a driver for his village's wealthiest man, to house Pomeranians, Puddles and Cuddles, and the rich man's very unlucky son. From behind the wheel of Honda City car, Balram's new world is a real vision. While his peers flip through the pages of Murder Weekly, barter for gulls, drink liquor and perpetuate the great rooster corp of Indian society, Balram watches his employers bribe foreign minister for tax breaks and play their own role in rooster corp. Balram learns how to siphon gas, deal and corrupt mechanics, and refill and resell John Walker label. He also finds a way out of the corp that no one else inside can perceive. Balram's eye penetrate India as a few outsiders. The cockroaches and the call centers, the prostitutes and the worshippers, the ancient and the internet culture, the water buffalo, and trapped in so many kinds of cages that escape is almost impossible. And here comes the White Tiger, and with a charisma as undeniable as it is unexpected, Balram teaches us that religion doesn't create virtue and money doesn't solve every problem, but decency can still be found in a corrupt world, and you can get what you want out of life if you eavesdrop on the right conversation. Let me summarize a bit for you. Here, Balram Halwai grew up in the darkness, the immense swath of ruler India, where the poor vastly outnumber the rich and where the right of the rich to oppress poor is rarely questioned. By dint of his intelligence and ambition, he becomes the number two driver to a local landlord nicknamed the Stroke. And when he discovers the number one driver has been hiding a secret, it ables to displace him and eventually move to Delhi with the landlord's westernized son, Mr. Ashok, and his modern wife, Pinky Madam. Quite early in the novel, Balram, who is writing a long letter to Chinese Premier Wen Jiabo, who is about to visit India, confesses that he has murdered Mr. Ashok, a crime that enabled him to move to Bangalore and set himself up as an entrepreneur. The flashback journey he relates in his letter describes how he became to that point, and in the process, it lays out a sardonic, sarcastic saga of the plight of India's poor. At one point, Balram tries to explain why the poor don't rise up to overwhelm their masters, and the best metaphor he can come up with is the chicken market in Old Delhi, where live roosters sit powerless in cages beneath the carcasses of their freshly slaughtered brothers. He writes, every day on the roads of Delhi, some chauffeur is driving an empty car with a black suitcase sitting on the back seat. Inside that suitcase is 1 million or 2 million rupees, more money that the chauffeur will ever see in his lifetime. If it took the money, he could go to America, Australia, anywhere and start a new life. He could not go inside the 5-star hotels he has dreamt about all his life and only seen from the outside. He could take his family to Goa, to England, yet he takes that black suitcase where its master wants to be. He puts it down where he is meant to and never touches a rupee. Why? Because Indians are the world's most honest people, like the Prime Minister's booklet will inform you. No, it's because 99.9% of us are caught in the rooster corp, just like those poor guys in the poultry market. This novel won the Booker Prize. It sparked outrage among many in India, but more than anything else, it tells us an entertaining tale with the strong, distinctive voice of a man whose soul had moved from servitude to independence and who, despite his horrified deed, finds the freedom to live by his own standard of decency. So this was the whole story of the book. Though you might want to watch its Netflix movie for getting a glimpse of today's India, let me know in the comments how you like the movie. See you in the next video.